come to Estoril, and they will spend a lot of time. And again, in reference to Ralf Schumacher, he's going to get lots and lots of testing. It will be carried out here in Estoril and other tracks around the world. Part of the development for any young driver is the physical development, as well as the stamina and concentration.
Actually, that's just the point I was going to refer to, John, looking at Ralf when he came in into the paddock earlier on today. Notice maybe it's a result of his Formula 3000 in Japan, but one notice I've seen from the difference between the end of last year when he was doing Formula 3 and now in Formula 3000 is the sheer size of his neck. It's really, he's got almost a straight neck down into his shoulders now, and that's presumably because of the high G-forces in Japanese 3000, where I think they use a more grippy tyre.
Well, there is tyre competition. A lot of the tyre companies in Japan are involved in the Nippon series, and of course they're allowed to use a variety of different tyres. And those cars are very, very quick cars, and especially in circuits like Suzuka, where you've got that series of long corners sweeping behind the pits. There, those cars grip. The only way you can survive is just to develop those muscles. So into the gym, lots of training, and of course more time in a car. And it is basically the time in the car that will affect the size of your physique, particularly the neck muscle size. It's very difficult to train the neck to cope with the kind of forces and loads that a racing car would generate.
So Ralf Schumacher will have experience of this circuit, as you mentioned. That's coming up in just a couple of weeks. He's got another race in the Formula Nippon series coming up at Suzuka next weekend, I believe. And then after that, he will be testing here at Estoril for Jordan Peugeot. Their plan to get him out as often as possible in a similar way to Williams Renault did with Jacques Villeneuve at the end of last